fighting contest, it is a 4-1 ball. Introducing first, from Wyoming, Young Pistol Steve.
Steve of the Young Pistols. He is prepared, and he is prepared to do battle against a big guy. This should be a tremendous contrast in styles and a great main event.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent. He will be accompanied by former heavyweight champion Harley Race from Kansas City. Weighing 365 pounds, the bodyguard, Mr. Hughes.
Mr. Hughes set to go in our main event. A couple of things I'd like to bring up, fans. Make sure you heard our Ross report where he talked to Harley Race about Mr. Hughes and about Steve Armstrong. You can join Jim on AM 750 WSB with the Jim Ross Show, where he'll take your calls and talk WCW wrestling and much more. That's tonight, starting at 9 o'clock on AM 750 WSB. And you've heard Missy Hyatt talk a lot about her hotline on Sunday nights. And yes, Missy Does the Mail is until midnight tonight, where you can call and listen to Missy talk. But if you like wrestling trivia, we invite you to call the wrestling hotline tomorrow, all day up until midnight. My segment, Tony Schiavone Talks, where we have wrestling trivia. We stump all the experts and like for you to call in with, see how you fare. That and much more. Tomorrow night, all day tomorrow, till midnight on the hotline. Now, Mr. Hughes, as anticipated, starting out quickly. And Steve of the Young Pistols using his quickness, sending Mr. Hughes down for a second time. This is good strategy by the youngster. You know, the Pistols have been so determined, even to the point of where they're turning their back on their fans and their friends. And Steve just trying to bring out that determination here. Mr. Hughes, as Steve used the quickness and rolled out of the way, goes up with a... Mr. Hughes, who exhibits a lot of quickness, and that was talked about in the Ross report, a little bit slow that time, enabling Steve not only to get up, but to move to the side and grab an arm. Steve holding on, and Mr. Hughes goes right up against the side of the head. Mr. Hughes, one of many superstars who will be with us at the Omni Thanksgiving night. That is this Thursday. It is the place to be. It is our Thanksgiving night super show. Fans, make sure you're on hand. Luger, Steiner, return match world title. And, of course, there's a foot. Sting and Ravishing Rick Rude with a gigantic return match. Ricky Steamboat, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, now a member of the World Tag Team Champions with the Natural Dustin Rhodes. You know, we've talked so much about the Steiner brothers as great World Tag Team Champions, but I cannot imagine a team any better than Ricky Steamboat and the Natural Dustin Rhodes at all. Reverse chin lock. As you take a look at Harley Race, we'll see if we can listen into some comments here.
Pull back on that head, Curtis. Pull back on that head.
I think that was pretty straightforward, and that's exactly what Mr. Hughes, he calls him Curtis, which is his first name, apparently. And Steve trying to get to his feet. Mr. Hughes is going to allow him to do that. To the eyes that time. Mr. Hughes, every time Steve gets an offensive move, he'll use a shortcut. Steve trying the sunset flip. He got him. One, two, and Mr. Hughes used those big legs just to get out of there. But give Steve a lot of credit. He may be somewhat of a turncoat as exhibited yesterday right here on TBS and World Championship Wrestling, but you can't deny his determination against a much bigger man. Wow. Right in the groin. Nick Patrick was behind Mr. Hughes that time, and that big body shielded him out. So Mr. Hughes, with a definite advantage now, is going to turn up the fire, so to speak. On the outside, Mr. Hughes, of course, all his power and all his strength. Can you imagine Mr. Hughes in the ring with Scott Steiner? And that will be part of our great action at the Omni this Thursday, Thanksgiving night, Battle Stars 91. A roll-in. Into the ropes. Flying body press. Mr. Hughes quickly got out of it. He's up again, and Steve sends him back down with an arm drag. Fans, also want to say hello to our great fans down in Key West, Florida. We'll be coming down to the stadium on Sunday, December 1st, starting at 12:30 in the afternoon. That's right. It's a matinee, and our great fans who watch us on TBS will be looking forward to seeing all the top superstars in Key West that Sunday afternoon. Big headbutt right on the back of the neck.
Get off there. Break it up. Get off there. Break the hole right now.
Neck bite supplied. He is calling for the break because the left hand is grabbing the hair.
Tell me, Ralph.
I'm telling you, you keep it up, you're out of here, pal. All right, get off the hair right now.
All right, Nick Patrick. You got to give Nick a lot of credit. He really asserts himself. And these big guys are certainly intimidating.
Off the rope.
Harley Race calling some directions. He's pointing Mr. Hughes to hit off the ropes on the other side. And Steve moved out of the way. Harley can brave himself with that one because Steve saw exactly what was coming, heard the footsteps, and moved over. Steve with an unkind word to Harley Race, and now he goes right to the head. Drop kick. Big man goes down. Steve with a foot. Got a two count on him. And Mr. Hughes just rolls out of it. Right to the eyes one more time. Where there's a will, there's a shortcut with Mr. Hughes. Fans, action like this, you'll be seeing at the Omni this Thursday. It's our Thanksgiving night super show. And of course, the Omni, you'll recall, it's always been a great event on Thanksgiving night. Years ago, we had Starcade there. And next week we'll be telling you more about Starcade, Battle Bowl, the Lethal Lottery, coming only on pay-per-view on Sunday, December 29th at 7 o'clock Eastern. That's our next pay-per-view extravaganza here in World Championship Wrestling. It should be a very unique event that you'll want to be part of. That time Steve luckily held the ropes because he was heading to the outside like a projectile, head first. Holding the ropes nearly to come down his feet, and there Harley gets in the low blow. It's very difficult when you're wrestling a Harley, or you're wrestling a Mr. Hughes or a Lex Luger, the world champion. It's basically, in this case, a two-on-one, or even when, like a Rick Steiner going after Luger at the Omni Thursday. It's a basic three-on-one, unless WCW asserts itself and makes sure Mr. Hughes is out of the ringside area, or even out of the building when that match takes place. Mr. Hughes will have all he wants with Scott Steiner. Much less being around for Lex Luger. Cover, that is a very, very arrogant cover, and Steve, showing his grit and determination, kicks right out. Glad to have you with us here on this great Sunday night for WCW Main Event here on TBS. Reverse chin lock applied. Steve has stayed in this match from the opening bell. And even though it's apparent he and Tracy, the Young Pistols, will do anything it takes to become U.S. Tag Team Champions, even do some underhanded stuff as you take a look at Harley. You got to give Steve some credit about his willingness to hang in here. The youngster is a top-notch athlete and will not give up. He may be a champion very soon. Mr. Hughes using the weight advantage. Steve is winded here, but he still moves out of the way, showing still some great quickness. That's made him one of the great tag team wrestlers in WCW for the last year. Clothesline, Mr. Hughes, drop kick. Mr. Hughes using the ropes as a support. Irish whip to the other side, flying elbow. Steve with a surge of adrenaline here, going up top, and this may be a mistake because Mr. Hughes up with it. Steve, up top. Mr. Hughes nailed him with a right hand to the chest as he went down. And Steve's in trouble. The high risk, youthful move, and Mr. Hughes with a spike slam. He will pin him.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, the bodyguard, Mr. Hughes.
I'll be back with Missy Hyatt in just a moment.
Steve of the Young Pistols and Mr. Hughes, what a tremendous match. And we want to remind the fans that, am I bothering you here by talking?
No.
Want to remind the fans that next week we have the York Foundation, the new World Six-Man Tag Team Champions.
I predicted it.
Against Beautiful Bobby and the Fabulous Freebirds. And that should be an exciting main event. In addition, we'll take a look back at Barry Windham and Ron Simmons together in a match before Barry's injury against the team of the Enforcers.
Well, I don't like any of those guys. The Enforcers scare me because they're so tough.
Let's talk about the Young Pistols and their change of attitude that we've seen over the last couple of weeks.
Well, I know all about that because I kind of like their new attitude. And I've been talking to Tracy and Steve, and I've got more scoops on the hotline about them. I know what changed their attitudes.
Is there anything that you don't know at all?
Mm-mm.
You probably didn't know that I'm on the hotline one day a week also.
Really?
Yeah. See? I'll have a scoop on that, too, about Missy Hyatt. And fans, we're Missy. I'm Tilly Schiavone. We'll see you.
Better not.